show you how to do routine cleaning on your pipes. Right now I'm going to show you some of the things that you're going to need in order to do a routine cleaning on your pipe. You're going to need some type of cleaning solution. I prefer grain alcohol. You're going to need pipe cleaners, both the bristle and the regular kind, the extra absorbent kind. You're going to need various sizes depending on your pipes, because not all pipes are the same. So I prefer to mainly use a tapered because they're thick on one end and thin on the other. But you're also going to need to use, you know, maybe some thin ones if your pipe can't take a thick pipe cleaner. I also like to use a shank brush because it's reusable. You can wash it with some dish soap, put it away to use it again, and it cuts down on the bristle pipe cleaners. You can do the main cleaning with the shank brush, and it'll cut down on the cost of using so many bristle pipe cleaners. You're also going to need some paper towels, a soft towel, and what I like to use, I use a little shot glass or something to put the alcohol in to help minimize so you don't spill it, because it's easier to knock over this tall bottle or whatnot than it would be to just knock over this glass. And plus, with the glass, you can also just stick your thing in it while it's in the alcohol and whatnot. You're also going to need some Q-tips. They're not necessary, but I find they work out pretty well for cleaning the rim and for also getting inside the shank of your pipe. It'll also cut down on the cost on some pipe cleaners, because sometimes the shank are a little bit thicker than what the pipe cleaner can get. And these are a little bit thicker, so it can get inside the shank of your pipe a little easier. And of course, you're going to need a pipe. Okay, so start by disassembling your pipe. That's pretty much removing the stem. If you have any removable bands, remove those as well. What I like to do to start off as a first step, I take a Q-tip and moisten it with saliva. Saliva works really well at removing the tar from the rims. And that's the first thing I do. It doesn't damage the thing, but you can see how much tar is coming off of the rim. I normally try to do this after every time I smoke a bowl out of the pipe to keep it from getting really built up on there and it becoming really hard to clean. So when I'm doing normal routine cleaning, it doesn't take a whole lot of extra time. So you keep moistening a clean part of the Q-tip with saliva and keep going until you've removed all of the tar from the rim. And once you get around to where it's not removing anymore, that's clean. Then what you want to do is, I have my cleaning solution in a little glass with the shank brush. Dip that into the shank brush, but before, dip the shank brush into the solution. But what I like to do is I take a paper towel and, you know, roll it up into a little tube and insert that into the bowl. That way it'll catch any of the excess cleaning fluid from rolling down and pouring out of the bowl and possibly ruining your finish, because you don't want to get any of the alcohol or cleaning solution on the finish of your pipe, because it can and it will strip it off. So once that procedure's done, I got that in there to protect it, and it'll also absorb any of the liquid. I take the shank brush, dip it in, and then I start going in and scrubbing it. And as you can see, it's getting quite a bit of the dirt out of there. And what I like to do to save a little bit of time, I'll take a Q-tip, dip it into the cleaning solution, and go into the shank and clean that, because the cotton on the Q-tip is a little bit wider than it's a lot wider than the shank brush, but a little bit wider than even the pipe cleaners. So it'll save a lot of time. Instead of using
so many pipe cleaners. You could tell it's doing a great job of cleaning the shank. Now I'm going to go back in with the shank brush and the bristle pipe cleaners and everything and get this thoroughly cleaned. But right now I'm going to show you, pretty much the same way on doing the stem. If the shank brush fits into the stem, you can go ahead and use that. And as you can see, the dirty solution is pouring out of the stem. So do that. If the shank brush is a little bit too thick for the stem, you can go with a bristle pipe cleaner and it'll work just as good. I just like using the shank brush to save on the cost of replacing so many bristle pipe cleaners. As you can tell, it's a little bit dirty. It's cleaning it out. You can tell from right there the dirty solution that's coming out of it. So I'm going to go ahead and finish cleaning. Remove your paper towel. As you can see, it absorbed all of the excess cleaning solution that rolled into the bowl. Now, it's going to look black and stuff. Don't worry, because it did soften your cake up, but you're supposed to let your pipe rest for a few days after you clean anyway. And that's just some of the tars and buildup that's down in your pipe. Make sure that you go through and dry it out with a nice, clean, dry pipe cleaner. And as you'll see, I pull it out and it's pretty much clean. Don't worry about if it's still a little bit dark and dirty down on the very tip of it, because that's the part that's going into your bowl and your cake is in there and everything, so it's going to look a little bit dirty on the end of your pipe. And then you reassemble your pipe. I like to blow through it to make sure that there's no little particles of the pipe cleaner or anything in there. And as you can see, I'll show you, by using the shank brush, it saved me quite a bit of, I guess you can say, money on pipe cleaners. I used in total 3 pipe bristle pipe cleaners for the stem and the pipe. I used 3 total Q-tips for the rim and inside the shank, and 1 thin regular pipe cleaner for the your stem, because on this stem, I couldn't get all the way in there with the shank brush or the bristle pipe cleaner. So once you're done that, your pipe's already clean and dry. Well, not dry, but you got all the excess fluid out. You're going to need to let this rest for a few days to completely dry out. Now for the final step, what I like to do, I take a little bit of extra virgin olive oil and apply it to the stem and the pipe. A lot of people don't like to use olive oil anymore, but people have been using extra virgin olive oil in their pipes for decades, and I've never heard of anybody having any problems. I've been using it on my pipes since I started smoking pipes, because that's what my grandfather used to do, and a lot of old timers used to do it, and I've never had any ill effects at all from using olive oil on my pipes. Let that sit there and dry a little bit. And normally what I will do is I'll let it dry a little bit longer than what I'm going to do here, but for the instructional purposes of the video, I take the soft towel and I'll buff it off. So now that that's buffed off, you can see that it has a nice shine on it. It has the protective coating on the stem from the olive oil filling up the little pores on the vulcanite, so it'll actually deter some of the oxidation buildup and gives you a nice clean shiny pipe. And there you have it. That's pretty much how you do a routine cleaning. Just remember, treat your pipes good, clean them on a regular basis, and they'll reward you with nice, sweet, relaxing smokes. I hope this video has been helpful to some of you, and we'll see you on PipesMagazine.com.